Chris Eubank Jr. is coming back to the ring off of a bit of a time away against the establishment in which he calls Scumbags. But Camille Shazmereta is a fighter who's challenging the position that Eubank is in so he can elevate himself further in the sport. Let's talk about this fight and what may be on the horizon for the winner. Coming up October 12th is finally the showdown between Artur Bitterbeev and Dimitri Bivol for the light heavyweight undisputed title. This is something that has been brewing and stewing for a long time, well over 5 years, and these two men will finally come together. It is highly anticipated, one of the cards of the year, where we will have a number of matches on the undercard leading up to the event that should entertain the masses tremendously. One curious match that is on the undercard will be the return to the ring of one Chris Eubank Jr. Yeah, the son of Chris Eubank, the legendary fighter from the UK, middleweight, super middleweight champion. We'll get a chance to see Eubank return after being away from the ring a little over a year. In his last match, where he scored a TKO victory over the previous conqueror of himself in Liam Smith. Now campaigning at this middleweight division, Eubank Jr. is looking to take on Camille Shazmereta, and this is a fight where it's kind of like you have to wait and see what type of a deal, because Eubank Jr. is not necessarily looking for the big fights. He's looking for securing paydays, which is not entirely the same thing. And in Shazmereta, he's finding a guy who, from Poland, happens to be a competitive fighter who has been in the ring with big names. His two losses have come to, most recent, it was Gennady Golovkin, Triple G. But he has bounced back from that with some balanced fights. His record now is 25-2-2 with 8 KOs. So he's not the kind of guy that's maybe going to get Eubank Jr. out of there. But he's going to be competitive. He's going to throw punches. He's going to be active. Now, he's a little shorter than Eubank. He's 5'9 and a half with a 73-inch reach, 35 years of age, and an orthodox fighter. But as I said, he is not going to be the type of guy to just come in and lay down against Eubank Jr. And I understand that Riyadh season is putting together competitive fights that we'll see these guys, even if this may not be a 50-50 fight, it's not the type of fight that Eubank is going to have where the opponent is going to just lay down. So his record of 33-3 with 24 KOs is probably going to get padded from this match, but it may not be as simple as people think. Just going back to his fight with Liam Smith, when he fought him the first time, which was in January of 2023, he suffered a TKO loss when he caught some punches along with a serious elbow that put him in jeopardy in that fight. Roy Jones Jr. was his trainer at the time, and Eubank Jr. had been fighting in a Roy Jones Jr. type manner, let's just say. That's how he approached that fight. And not having Jones's like skills led to he being vulnerable against Liam Smith. Shazmereta comes in as a fighter who throws a high volume of punches. As I said, he's not a big puncher, but he can get in there and mix it up. Against Golovkin, he showed that he was definitely game, but he had difficulty due to Gennady's power. Gennady's powerful jabs and hooks to the body and head put him in jeopardy early as the first round. But he comes back, and he's a fighter that will keep his hands up. He will dip, he will punch, he will jab, he will throw combinations, he will work the body. He's not a guy who is an easy to figure out fighter. He has boxing ability, but I think the lack of power is where he runs into problems. And in the middleweight division, there are not a number of power punches, but most of the men punch with a great deal of strength. His 8 knockouts show that he is just not up to par there. Now, Eubank Jr., when he's on, he can look very good. His rematch against Liam Smith stood out. He was able to do some things against Liam that led people to believe that he was a lot better than advertised in the first go round. And as long as he got away from doing what Roy Jones Jr. had him doing, and how, you know, I noticed right away his hands were up and he was throwing out of a boxer's position combinations, and he attacked Beefy the way he was supposed to. And that was the talent that a lot of people saw from Eubank before he got with Roy Jones Jr. Now, Cesar Romero is going to also come in and probably try to exchange with Eubank, because he may find that Eubank Jr. has openings. Beefy found them. And though he fought better in the rematch against Beefy, you know, he was trying to have his get back. But this is now after a year and a month or so of a layoff, he's back in the ring and he's going to have to fight. And Camille is not the kind of guy that's just going to submit and give in to him there. At least that's not the disposition that he has shown on a regular basis as he fights. One of the things that I also like about this opportunity for Eubank coming back is if he is totally over that knockout loss to Beefy, he can come back and put his name in the stakes for better competitive fights, especially participating in Riyadh season. He may not get called back for Riyadh season due to his outbursts at the presser that led up to this event, where he called his former promoters and the others participating in this Scumbags. And he was very vehement in his expression and talking down about Matchroom Boxing, Queensberry Boxing, and he's now with Boxer, with Ben Shalom. Will he be able to overcome those circumstances with a performance that has Prince Turki Alekşik and Riyadh Season calling him back? That remains to be seen. Now, as far as Camille is looking for this opportunity. That's why he can't be overlooked in this. Guys who have been in this position in these Riyadh events have stepped up and they have shown some things. You can look back at Ajit Kabiel and think about how he was able to turn his career up as he got a chance to be highlighted on these Riyadh season cards. And he has performed very well. And Camille could do the same thing. If he comes in, uses his skill set, boxes, not allow himself to get caught cleanly, and move around and play the boxing game. I don't believe that Chris Eubank Jr. is that much of a better boxer than he is. He may have more strength and power, and he may be a bit more athletic. But we question what's going on psychologically with Eubank Jr. because just like his dad, he can be a bit of an enigma. You don't know what you're going to get when he's doing his thing. You just know that he's going to be in there. He's going to show some vulnerabilities, and he may even show some exciting offensive aspects to his game. But all in all, this is what probably makes this fight, I want to say 70-30 in favor of Eubank Jr. And if he's bringing those aspects of what I talked about, his vulnerabilities, into this fight, it could be more of a 60-40. But what do you think? This is Stormy B-Man. Shout out to the mighty LDBC and Liberated Perspective, a third eye view of the world. For more content such as this, please like, comment, subscribe, and share. Let's have a further discussion as we lead up to this big event. Peace to everyone out there, and everyone, please remain safe.